Hello. I've met many people who are familiar with the services VA provides veterans, but are unaware that VA conducts health research. They are unaware that some of our researchers have won Nobel Prizes for their work. They are unaware that it was VA researchers who conducted the study that helped bring about such advances as cardiac pacemaker, the CT scan, and nicotine patches. And they are unaware that the work of VA researchers is published regularly in the world's leading medical and scientific journals, and that this important work plays a key role in improving veterans' lives. VA's research program has been called the crown jewel of the department, and I believe that description is an accurate one. I'm proud of what our researchers have accomplished on behalf of our veterans and on behalf of all Americans and people around the globe. I encourage you to learn more about VA research through this video and the other information available through our Office of Research and Development.
This is really one of the great purposes of VA research, is to help veterans and understand their conditions and find treatments for the conditions that are specific to what they get while they were in the military. VA conducts research to find new ways of diagnosing and treating disease. If VA and others didn't conduct research, we would be stuck where, you know, we were 100 years ago or 200 years ago or maybe in the Middle Ages. So society needs to support this so that we find treatments for conditions, find new ways of diagnosing conditions, find ways of preventing conditions. And, you know, we've done that. So as we make progress in these things, we will find ways to treat individuals and find ways to make them better. The biggest challenge to run a major research program, for everyone who runs a major research program, is to make the most use of the resources. The VA, compared to some programs, and some people would say it's a modest budget, it's really not, but I think to make the most, to get the most research, the most help for people out of that, out of those resources is the biggest challenge. One of the challenges, I think, for everyone in the VA is we have such a large organization, it's all over the country, and we have to somehow figure out how to maintain communication. And research has kind of a special problem because it can't be top down. It has to be partly you guide it, but partly it depends on the creativity of the researchers. So our challenge is to enhance the creativity of researchers and at the same time guide the research in the right direction. One of the biggest, and everybody considers it one of the great breakthroughs, certainly of this decade and so far of this century, is the brain-computer interface, where again, a woman's thoughts, and a man, both men and women actually were in the study, her thoughts moved a prosthetic arm. And that's a great breakthrough, and you can just imagine what can come out of that in the future, moving limbs and all kinds of things. I think that the DECA arm has been a great breakthrough, and it also shows the value of collaboration, because we collaborated with the Department of Defense, with DARPA, and it was a great collaboration that produced a lot. But then there are the smaller things, and as you mentioned, they are extremely important. And a lot of small things we do, and these kinds of findings come out every week, are about the healthcare system. Little improvements in the healthcare system that our health services researchers find and publish and talk about, showing how you can improve scheduling or some other aspect, and that can accumulatively has a tremendous effect, and I think those are very important. Our overall goals have not changed much over these 8 years. I think the details have changed because we have findings, and then based on those findings we move ahead. So the research projects depend on previous findings and the situation of war has not changed. We deal with veterans in the long term. So the fact that the war ends won't change the fact that we have to deal with these conditions when they come back. It is very important that veterans and the nation at large know about VA research so that one is they know what benefits have been derived from it and that they know why people are spending money on it. So I think it's very important that the public at large know about VA research. It's very difficult because most people don't think that VA does research. They don't know that VA does research. Even many veterans don't. And we have done our best over the last 8 years to make at least veterans aware of it and at least make those who are stakeholders, veteran service organizations and others like that, aware of what we're doing. One of the important things that veterans should know is that their participation in research is crucial. We can't do that. We can't do research without their help. And that's another reason why veterans need to know about it, because they are altruistic people. They do participate in research, I think, more readily than others. They do not only for their own benefit, which research can derive, but for the benefit of others. And it's very important that they know that they have this opportunity to do that, because if they know about it, we find that they will do it. Veterans are greatly involved, and veteran service organizations are greatly involved in VA research, and they've been wonderful. Veterans themselves volunteer for projects more readily, I think, than others, and they are very appreciative. The veteran service organizations also have had a number of special roles. Firstly, they've advocated for VA research in many quarters. They've also directly helped in research projects. They've informed veterans about projects such as the Million Veteran Program and other research projects. They've been part of studies, they've advocated for studies, and they've informed veterans of studies. And therefore, I think the veteran service organizations or us are in the same business. We're here to help veterans, and I think we've joined together in many ways to do that. Certainly, we've moved along in a number of areas well, and I think we've moved along in the post-deployment conditions. We've built a large infrastructure of personnel and equipment and other things to do this kind of research. I think the research has been very productive. I think also that society and the government has been generous with us in increasing the funding over the years, and that's helped tremendously. And I think we are very thankful that has happened. And again, our biggest challenge is to spend that money wisely and get the most out of each dollar for the benefit of veterans and society. I think that what attracts clinicians about research is, and this is very important to VA research, where over 60% of our researchers do clinical care. I think what attracts them is they see things that they can't do. They see conditions that they just don't have a treatment for. And I think that's what attracts clinicians to research. And it's also, there are some personal things about it. It's creative, it's satisfying. You have a product that you've produced, and that's, I think, very satisfying to people. Once you do it, and once you see the results, and particularly if you can see the results on patients, which you can when you're a clinician, then it's the most satisfying thing there is. I think the future of research is extremely bright, and I think there are wonderful projects that have been put in place, like the Million Veteran Program. I think the Million Veteran Program is going to change the way medicine is practiced in the future. I think the other research will continue and thrive. I think it has a very bright future. I think there's an understanding among those who decide on these things that VA research is important, that there's a much greater understanding, I think, within the government and in the stakeholders about how beneficial this program is. And I think that will also serve as an infrastructure and foundation for its future, its good health in the future.